last lecture of this course, Semiconductor Devices. So in this course we have 4 lectures per week, and this course has 4 credits, and we have to spend about 60 hours to complete this course. In this course we will study about semiconductor devices and some physical properties of these semiconductor devices. So this is the syllabus of this course. That is, this course has 4 units. In unit first we will study about some basic properties of semiconductors. In second unit we will study about some basic properties of junctions, that is, how can we make semiconductor devices using these junctions. And in unit 3 and 4 we will study about some electronic or semiconductor devices. So these are some references for this course. That is, first one is J.J. Cathey. This book is very good for this course. And the second book is also good for these two books. That is, at number 1 and 2 are good for unit 1 and unit 2, but these books are very helpful for unit 3 and unit 4. For unit 1st and unit 2nd you can also look for the book written by Donald A. Neiman with the title Semiconductor. Physics and devices. This book is very important for unit 1st and 2nd, and you can also look for the book written by S. O. Kassab with title Principle of Principles of Electronic Materials and Devices. There are some other good books also, that is written by SMZ, and you can also look for the book written by S.O. Pillai. So these are some good books for this course. And as you know, this is our timetable for semester 1st. So in this timetable we can see that we have a class on Tuesday from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. and second class we have on Wednesday from 9 to 10 a.m. We don't have any class on Thursday and on Monday, also on Saturday, and we have 2 classes on Friday. First one from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. and then from 11 a.m. to 12 p.m. So these are our 4 lectures per week, and I am uploading video lectures for this course on Tuesday, Wednesday and Friday. And in this lecture, I will be taking your online classes. So if you have any doubts regarding these three lectures, then I will try to resolve all of your doubts on this in this lecture. So this is all about our timetable. These are some important instructions you have to follow. For this course, there will be an online multiple choice question type test after completion of each unit. So you have to give a multiple choice question test after every unit, and all four tests are compulsory. You can't skip any of these tests. And third one, there will be two assignments. First assignment will be given after completion of first and second units, and second assignment will be given after completion of third and fourth units. And again, both of these assignments are compulsory. And I am going to post every video lecture on this website. So this website is maintained by our university. You will get your username and password in coming days. So after login to this website, you can see this course in your profile. And at when we have our lecture time, that is on Tuesday, Wednesday and Friday, you will get a video lecture on this LMS website. And most of the time I am going to mark your attendance based on your visit on this website. So please always try to log into this website when we have lecture. So these are some important instructions regarding this course. I hope you will enjoy this course. Thank you.